Okay, so now let's look at the highest frequency possible. So highest frequency. So how do we get that? Remember, the highest frequency is just simply that we have samples alternating going up and down. So these are single samples. So that's n, that's x of n. And in order to achieve that, in the frequency spectrum, what we do is we're setting the middle coefficient to one. So let's just write our inverse Fourier transform there again. So that's x over n, then the sum is k from 0 to n minus 1. So these are our frequency coefficients, x of k, e to j 2 pi k n divided by n. And so now when we're looking at these x of k's here, so then our x of 0, that's 0. And then this stays 0 up to x of n half, so it's an n. So that one here, so we set this to 1. And then the rest here again, up to x of n minus 1 here, all that here stays 0. So let's have a look how this resolves. So therefore, we have again 1 over n. So the sum here is no longer there. And so then we have only x of n half, and that is 1. And then we need to look here at the exponential here. So that's then e to j 2 pi. And so the k index running here, this is n half, and then n, and then the whole thing divided by n. And so we see already, so the two cancels out, the n cancels out here, and we are just left with a pi n here. And so if I just do this here, 1 over n, and then we have here an e to j pi n. So that's all what is left. So then so what does it mean? So remember, the n is an integer, and for this 2 pi, it rotates around the complex plane here. So if this is here real and this is imaginary, then so if n is 0, then we're getting a pure real value here. And then if n is 1, then it flips to the other side of that here, again a real value. And then so further, it just continues like this. So then basically, what we have here, we have a value here, and then a value here. And so then as we know, this is here a 1, and this is a minus 1. And so with that we are getting exactly what we want here. So we're getting a 1 here, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, and so on. And so the question is now, do we see that also in our Fourier transform, just as a sanity check, if this works? So let's create again loads of zeros. There we have them, and so now I just need to create basically a 1 in the middle. So length of x divided this by 2, and we set this to 1. So then there should be a 1 somewhere. Yeah, there's a lone 1 in the middle here. So if we now do the inverse Fourier transform. And let's have a look here at the XF. And so we see here that, so the samples next to each other, we see that the real values are just flipping the sign here, positive, negative, positive, negative, and so on. And so therefore, if you plot this here, again, there's just to make it real. So now we see this quite solid square here. It's obviously because the frequency is very high. So if I zoom in there, so now we see here it starts at zero at a positive value, negative, positive, negative, positive. That's what we were expecting from this diagram here. Yeah, so remember this formula here that we had these alternating values, 1, minus 1, and remember this divided by number of samples n. That's the reason why it's 0.01. And so that's what we were hoping to expect here, and we see this works. So now we have created all the positive frequencies, and so now we just move on explaining why there's actually more frequencies here beyond the midpoint. So what is happening for beyond n half years? So basically in this region here, what is the meaning of that?